Hello, my name is Paul Rissman, and I'm going to guide you through the fourth movement of the Planets, Jupiter, the Bringer of Jollity. In this movement, Holst seems to have been inspired by astronomy as well as astrology. Jupiter has the fastest rotation of any planet in our solar system, and Holst appears to represent that fact by asking the violins to play a tiny three-note figure over and over very quickly. On top, the main theme is quirky and syncopated, and it's sounded out by six horns and the entire forces of the viola and cello sections. A real masterstroke in Holst's orchestration is in his use of the timpani. Here in Jupiter, Holst's timpani writing is truly virtuosic, and he maximises the luxurious position of having two sets of timpani in the orchestra. So the theme we just met in the horns is also played by the timps. Notice how, in order for the timps to play the entire theme, Holst has to share the music between two players so they cover all the notes. Melodically, Jupiter is by far the richest and most appealing in the suite. It's literally bursting full of great tunes, such as this one. Typically with Holst, just as your ears get used to the march-like umcha feel to this music, everything changes when he introduces another theme in a completely different time signature. Incredibly, there's one more theme to listen for, and this one is even more impressive. In popular culture, this next theme lives a double life as either the hymn tune, I Vow to Thee My Country, or the theme tune to the Rugby Union World Cup. To my sadly non-athletic ears, I hear a beautiful melody which effortlessly paints a lush landscape, much more like the English countryside than a monstrously large planet filled with poisonous gases.